duck, yeah. Now this afternoon, you'll all be taking part in one of the South's finest known traditions, the tradition of the Peabody Duck March. Now the tradition of the Peabody Duck March was started many, many years ago, way, way back in the 1930s, up at the first Peabody in Memphis, Tennessee. Now the general manager there in Memphis was Mr. Frank Shutt. And one day, Mr. Frank Shutt decided him and his buddy Jim Barwick would spend the afternoon duck hunting. So they loaded up all of their equipment, which included their live duck decoys. Because you see, in the 30s, it was still legal to use live duck decoys to call in the ducks and hunt. So they loaded up their equipment, live ducks and all, got them into their truck, and then they took the long drive all the way from Memphis to fabulous L.A., which is, of course, just Lower Arkansas. When they got down to Lower Arkansas, the country's finest areas for duck hunting to this day, they hunted for the entire day, but sadly they didn't get a single duck while they were out. So they took a long, slow, sad drive all the way back to Memphis. Now when they got back to Memphis, since they had such a dismal duck hunting experience, they decided to lift their spirits by, of course, downing their spirits. And feeling a little bit genius after they had done that, they decided to take their live decoy ducks and sneak them into the lobby fountain of the Peabody Memphis. And after they had done that, they snuck up to their rooms to sleep everything up. Well, when the two of them got back down the next morning, they noticed that, well, the ducks were still inside of the fountain and they hadn't gotten out during the night. And they also noticed that the hotel lobby was packed with hundreds of people who had heard about the ducks swimming in the fountain of the Peabody Memphis. And all these people, they wanted to go and see it for themselves. And Mr. Frank Shutt, being the general manager that he was ecstatic to see all the attention and popularity that the hotel was getting. So he made sure the ducks were inside the fountain every single day. Now this went on for some time without any changes until 1939. Because in 1939, right outside the city of Memphis, there was a train wreck. Now this train wreck belonged to Ringling Brothers Barnum and Bailey Circus. And on the train was Mr. Edward Pembroke. Now Mr. Pembroke was a wild animal trainer with this circus, and since the train had derailed, he was out of the yard. So he came on staff to the Peabody Memphis as a bellman. Now when Mr. Pembroke arrived at the Peabody Memphis, he of course noticed the ducks inside the fountain, but he wanted to put his personal talents to the best use he could. He wanted to give people the Peabody Service Excellence experience the hotel was and still is known for. So what he did was he asked Mr. Shutt if he could train those ducks to march up and down in the elevators, down the red carpet, up the stairs and into the fountain every day, coming down at 11 and going back up at 5. Now, he did such a fantastic job marching those ducks in Memphis that Mr. Shutt made him the first official Peabody Duckmaster. And he was marching ducks up there in Memphis from 1940 all the way until 1991. Now, we'd like to continue the fine, fine tradition that Mr. Pembroke started those many, many years ago up in Memphis. We're here in Little Rock as well as down in Orlando, where our third Peabody is. We march our ducks just like he did when they come down at 11 from their four-star duck accommodations outside of the ballroom terrace. And of course, having them go up at 5. So, without any further ado, I would like to present to you all this afternoon's Peabody Duck March. Because you know what they say, once you have seen the ducks march, you can go on with the rest of your lives.
Ladies and gentlemen, good evening. May I have your attention, please? Back in the 1930s, in the lobby fountain of the Peabody Memphis, a unique tradition began which has made the South's Grand Hotel famous the world over. If I may now direct your attention to the fountain and outline, you will witness here in Little Rock a continuation of that time-honored tradition, an experience uniquely yours as a guest of the Peabody Little Rock. Preparing to return to the Royal Duck House for the night, ladies and gentlemen, the March of the Peabody Duck.